Hello everyone, I would like to present you our experience and practices to tackle soil erosion on an organic farm in South Moravia. This presentation was made for Best for Soil project workshop. My name is Adam Brezáni and I work for a company called Probio Obchodní Společnost as a project manager. Probio is the first and biggest organic food processor in Czech Republic and also distributes certified organic seeds. Probio is a sister company of an organic farm Veľkého Šťavátky Agroton. There is a close cooperation between Probio and the farm. I'm in charge of several research projects at Probio and Agroton as well. Agroton is a national demonstration farm granted by Ministry of Agriculture in Czech Republic. This means that every year we organize several events, seminars and workshops with the farmers on certain topics. We have been in the program for 3 years and we are planning to extend it. Most of the farm's production is bought by Probio, and this covers about 10 to 15% of Probio's demand. Farm also multiplies seeds for Probio. The farm and Probio are about 170 kilometers away one way. The farm transports the production to Probio's mills in North Moravia, while Probio provides feed for animals at the farm in form of husks and other byproducts from flour production. This way we can have the semis used for transportation loaded both ways each time. Agroton has been fully certified organic farm for more than 10 years. Operation has 376 hectares. This is an aerial photo of our farm. The farm site is being shared with three other subjects. Zonentor, that uses it for herbs production and drying. Vesela Biofarma, which is an educational center for organic farming and gardening. Social enterprise Yasan for disabled and handicapped people. The farm has 4 full-time employees and 2 part-time employees. The farm owns most of the crucial machinery except the combine and a baler. Soil harvesting is being outsourced. Rarely we ask for help with cultivation or spelt drilling. It can be tricky to drill spelt with our mechanical Wetterstadt rapid drill. If the seed delivered is too light, we rather ask neighbors with a pneumatic drill. The farm is located in a hilly area with heterogeneous soil conditions. Soil types vary from clay, sand, loess on different parcels. However, it is mostly clay. pH value varies from 7 to 8 carbonated soils. About 80% of soils are erosion threatened. Farm is located in semi-arid area with annual precipitation of 450 mm and average temperature of 10 degrees Celsius. 1/3 of land is owned by Agroton, the rest is being leased from various owners. These are crop yields of past 2 seasons. This season was particularly good for wheat and spelt, where we also had good qualitative parameters. Oats were better last year than this year. Both years were about average in precipitation. I do not have stats for buckwheat yet, and peas were not grown this year. What are we doing to improve our soil health? One of the most important aspects is a crop rotation. Using short rotation with loads of cover crops and legumes. We try not to leave any bare soil for a longer time period except before drilling early spring crops such as peas, field peas and oats. We still need to figure out a way to use cover crops before those cash crops since the cover crop might be contradictory in terms of soil temperature. Preventing the soil to warm up in early spring or cover crop might be just hard to work with in early spring. We thought about using frost-kill cover crops or even mechanically terminating it in December, while leaving the remains on top of the soil during winter. I want to point out 2 important crops for soil health in the rotation. The first is alfalfa and the second one is buckwheat. This is a photo of stubble right after oats harvest with intercrop alfalfa. The legume is intercropped while drilling oats using additional hopper on the drill. This is usual way. If the intercropping fails for some reason, we drill alfalfa into shallowly cultivated soil. Alfalfa is the most important crop for the farm in terms of soil health. It can help with weed control. We usually do not have problems with annual weeds, but with perennial weeds, especially field thistle and couch grass. Alfalfa helps to keep those weeds under control, but it is crucial to keep the stand for 2 years. 1 year lay doesn't seem to outcompete the weeds very well from our experience. Alfalfa is crucial in fertility management as it is a nitrogen fixer. Roots also aerate the soil and improve the soil structure. Alfalfa provides feed for pigs in form of haylage and hay. The farm has an organic pigs feedlot with annual production of 350 to 400 pigs. Also producing manure, which we use for amending the soil with. Beside pig manure, we buy cow manure and compost to spread on fields. We also have 20 sheep that we use to mow the farm's area. Alfalfa also has an economical perspective. We sell it in form of hay, and we will try haylage in future as well. We cut the alfalfa 3 to 4 times a year. Sometimes we mulch it to create denser stand. Mulching helps the stand to regenerate and keeps the plant active. We do not want the crop to get lazy with fixing nitrogen. Buckwheat is another important crop in the rotation, which feeds the soil life and helps to increase the phosphorus availability in the soil. It is important for soil health, but hard to justify the cost as a cash crop. You might end up even or in red numbers by growing buckwheat. It helps us to justify the cost if grown as a relay crop or substitution crop. Crimson clover or winter mixtures are usually harvested late in the spring to have enough time window for drilling buckwheat as a second crop, while still being able to harvest it before frost during October or early November. This is an intensification method to utilize the field during the whole year. I also want to show you an example of buckwheat as a substitution crop. This was a field of spring peas that were heavily infested by wild oats. The wild oats simply outcompeted the peas. There was no point of keeping it. Unfortunately, I do not have a photo of the stand. You hardly could see any peas in it. In early June, the peas were mulched, left on top of soil for 3 days to reduce in biomass. The residues were shallowly cultivated into the soil using Wetterstadt carrier with cross-cutter disc. This created very light mulch on top of soil. The stand after a week of drilling with Wetterstadt rapid. The stand in late September. Very homogeneous, lush and mostly wheat-free stand. We think it is better to react early and try a substitution crop rather than leaving unprospective cash crop or bare land for a few months until fall. If the buckwheat doesn't matter, we incorporated it as a cover crop. These are our currently used cover crop mixtures. The first mixture consists of 8 components, usually used after cereal harvest. The stand is kept until fall when it's plowed into the soil. Winter mixtures are not purebred cover crops, but they cover the soil during the whole winter and in the springtime are harvested as feed for animals. Usually buckwheat or sorghum is drilled right afterwards. Also, quite good cover crops are field peas and volunteer crimson clover, where the loss after the combine is quite high. We simply initialize the volunteer seeds with shallow cultivation while adding a second component, a mustard, during the process of cultivation. Volunteer crimson clover is used more as undersow in buckwheat, where it doesn't compete with buckwheat and doesn't bother during harvest either. Using it this way, you can still fix some nitrogen and provide quicker canopy closure to prevent soil erosion during heavy rains or to compete weeds. Some photos for illustration of seed color variation in mixture. In the following 3 photos, it is the same mixture with 8 components on 3 different plots. The prevalence of some species at each field is quite different. This fact helps us as we farm in very heterogeneous conditions, and the multi-component mixtures help us in creating enough biomass volume that can be incorporated into the soil. This is a winter mixture which consists of rye, hairy wedge and crimson clover. The picture is taken moments before we use the stand for direct drilling of buckwheat. I will talk about it in a minute. Establishing cover crops. Since we pay for the seed, it is very important to treat it the way that it will produce enough biomass, which is the most important aspect which we are looking for while using cover crops. Establishment method is usually depending on actual soil conditions. Either shallow tillage with our new Wetterstadt carrier with cross-cutter disc is used that incorporates the residues while mixing the soil shallowly. The cross-cutter discs are placed at angle of 14 degrees to provide 100% soil surface coverage during cultivation, while the standard discs cover about half of the soil surface. The massive yellow pucker wheels in the rear helps to cut off the capillarity for additional moisture loss from the soil. Our Wetterstadt carrier is equipped with custom-built extended biodrill with higher hopper capacity, so the driver doesn't need to stop that often when drilling. This machine is a real change for our operation, since it can do several tasks at once. Incorporating and shallowly cultivating the soil, initializing the voluntary seeds, weed seeds and drilling. Since the cover crops mixed with weeds are terminating before the seed shattering, it helps to lower the weed seed bank in the soil. If the conditions are good, weed-free, we can use our Wetterstadt Rapid for direct drilling into the stubble. This is a quicker method than using Wetterstadt carrier, since you do not need to refill the hopper as much with seed. And the drill has a set of discs that can cultivate the soil lightly as well. Another way to make the soil healthier and prevent soil erosion is a practice of contour cultivation. This is a simple solution to deal with soil erosion, plus if used with shallow cultivation, for example, for drilling buckwheat, sorghum or cover crops, it can protect the soil by leaving residue remains from previous crop on top of the soil. The heavy rains in early summer can be devastating in terms of soil erosion and crop establishment. Also, we try to remodel the landscape. It is important to cultivate the way that can reduce the risk of water runoff. Since the fields are not quite square, it is always a compromise to find the most suitable direction. The same field before harvest. Cultivation of the field. We plant tree orchards while remodeling the landscape to prevent soil erosion. At the moment, we are practicing partial low disturbance cultivation. It is partial because we still use a plow. We are trialing some methods and slowly adopting them. It is a long-term approach. As mentioned, the Wetterstadt carrier is the newest tool as we are adopting low disturbance cultivation. Another great advantage of this machine is its working speed. We can drive up to 20 km an hour, which makes it very efficient. We have used it in our buckwheat direct drilling experiment, where it was used for rolling the winter cover crop mixture, rye, hairy wedge and crimson clover. We have trialed several methods of stand termination before direct drilling. Mulching the cover crop, rolling the cover crop, harvesting the biomass for feed and drilling into stubble afterwards, traditional method by disking the stubble and drilling into cultivated land, and finally, direct drilling into winter mixture stand. We have used Slybos direct drill for trials. This is the direct drilling into cover crop winter mixture. The drill's weight was used to roll and terminate the cover crop. Among all trial variants, the rolled cover crop and traditional cultivated land were visually the best options. In the rolled variant was a problem with Italian ryegrass, which was accidentally included in winter cover crop mixture. However, this hasn't created a problem for buckwheat to compete. The results were affected by sufficient rainfalls during June and July. Without rainfalls, the difference could be more visible. This is the direct drilling into living mulch variant. The cover crop was not knocked to the ground by the drill and rye managed to regenerate. After a few days, we mulch the regenerated stand cover crop with lifted flail mower. But additional driving over the field created tractor tracks which were full of weeds. The uniform stand of buckwheat in world variant. What are the challenges regarding the soil health? One of the challenges is the reduction or elimination of plowing at the farm. The drawbacks of this type of cultivations are very well defined. We are trying to find alternative ways to incorporate cover crops, manures and compost into the soil profile. Navigation without GPS on fields full of residues or cover crops can be very challenging for drivers. Introduction of controlled traffic is one of the priorities at the farm. If everything goes well during the season and you did your homework right, then you can enjoy pictures like this. This is during the harvest of einkorn, harvest of sorghum, harvest of buckwheat. At the end, I would like to ask fellow soil farmers several questions that can be discussed during the workshop. Is anyone practicing long-term cultivation without plowing in organic system? What are your cover crops components and how would you deal with our problem of early spring crops in terms of using cover crops instead of plowing? Has anyone tried winter freeze cover crops without incorporation into the soil? Are you doing soil tests? How often and what are you focused on? And do you have problems with field mouse in your countries? Thank you for your attention. Special credit for awesome photos goes to Martin Matej. If you have any questions, please do not hesitate to contact me at the email address provided or phone number. Thank you.